Hey y'all, Surfing SAPO here. Today is May 29th, 2014. H-E-B has sardines. Sardines. It's a fish. They're flash frozen on the boat. Not clean. I'm going to have to take the guts out and clean them up a little bit. But what we're going to do, we're gonna grill them on the Weber Smokey Mountain or cook them at a high temp. Not grill them this far. We're going to cook them at a high temp, let's say. Anyway, fairly simple. Just add sea salt, a little bit of a lemon, a little bit of olive oil, and lay it on some aluminum foil. Let them rip. So, like I always say, let's get started. I did something stupid, too. I washed the remote control in my shorts from yesterday, and now the start-stop button doesn't work. Some of the other buttons work. I've washed it out with corrosion block and then gun scrubber and got some of it to work, so maybe the rest will come back later. Who knows? Let's see. I'll push stop right now. Nothing. See? So I got to walk up here, old school style, and hey, what's up? And shut it off. So, okay, here's our sardines here. Pretty much all you got to do is take a little knife, insert it in the back. When I say back, the back of the stomach. Cut them down the belly like any regular fishy. And then you're just, it's real bloody, so we got to take the guts out, you know, like a regular fish. So I'm going to do that. I'm not going to do it here, but I'm going to clean all the guts out. And it's like a little mackerel, see? Virtually is. So we'll clean them up and then we'll season them up and we'll get started. Okay, they've all been gutted and cleaned. Now we're going to take some olive oil and just dribble it across them. Get it on, make sure you get it everywhere. I'm going to use all this up. Olive oil, just plain old olive oil from Italy, the expensive kind. I don't usually buy that, but it was on sale at H-E-B. Then I'm going to use some truffle salt. You can just use regular salt, but I prefer to use this. It has a real nice flavor. Whoop. Let's sprinkle it on. They're salty, but we're going to salt them up a little more. Okay. Then, some oregano. We'll squeeze lemon juice on them as they're grilling. There we go. All right. Now, I'm going to insert them in a contraption, and I'll be right back. Okay, here's the contraption. I'll let you see it. It's a fish basket. It's made for one fish. But since these are little fishes, they're little one fishes. Let's lay them in. Fit about as many as you can in there. Might be able to get five or six. I'm going to put the small guys first. Do the big ones at the end. Maybe one more. Small guy, if I have any more small ones. That looks like a small one. There we go. See? See how they fit in there? Isn't that beautiful? Then, you shut it on the fishies. Like so. And back here you have a ring. You push the ring up here. About right there, wherever you want it. So now see, they're in there. They're not going to fall out. And I can also turn it over, put my spices on this side. So let's go ahead and put a little more oregano. And some salt. A little bit of salt. lot of salt. There we go. Sardines, ready for the grill. So let's go out back next, okay? We're out back now. This is some little Mexican lemons I have. They're virtually the same thing as a key lime. If you notice, they're very small. But boy, these things are quite juicy and they're tasty. We're going to be squeezing these on the sardines that are in the grilling cage. Alright? Alright, we've got a super hot fire here on the Weber Smokey Mountain 14.5. I'm going to lay them on right here in the middle. We're getting a little bit of fire going on in the bottom. I also made some in a cast, or in the, I'm going to do these later. But I made some also in the aluminum foil. So just let these cook and we'll check on them now and then, okay? Alright, here's these little lemons I got. We're just going to squeeze some lemon juice on these babies. It's a nice hot fire. Very hot. Now this is really grilling. Yesterday wasn't. This is a very, very hot fire. Okay. And this is canola oil. You can spray that on there, but I'm not. If you wanted more oil, you could do it. But I don't want to see a big old whoosh. Yeah, we could do it. What the heck? No guts, no glory, right? There. Not too bad. You just don't want it to go down there and boom! Catch fire. 10 minutes on each side. That's what we're shooting for, folks. Coming along well, folks. Still got about another 6 minutes to go on this side. In my time. In your time, it'll be next time I come back. Okay, been 10 minutes. Let's just take a peek, a gander. I want to see them browned up. Oh yeah, oh yeah. That's what we're talking about. Can y'all see that? I know you can. Don't kid me. That's beautiful. That's literally a piece of work, art. Even Bob Guido would even eat that, I believe. Alright, I'm going to take the lemons again. Let me get out of the sunlight. Just squeeze some lemons on there. Throw them in there. They're biodegradable, no biggie. Getting a little bit of back. A little bit of ashes coming up, but that's okay. Ain't going to stay no how. There we go. About another 6-7 minutes. Alright folks, these babies are done. I'm going to take them off, just set them in the pan like this and let them rest before I take one out and test it for you, okay? They're pretty hot. In the meantime, what I got here is the last three, and I put them in this heavy duty aluminum foil with olive oil, oregano, all the goodies except for the lemon, salt, everything. And this is like the way we did the pompanos at the beach, if you recall, with the olive oil and the Creole seasoning from Zatarain's, the chunky, zesty. But this is a different fish, but I believe it'll come out the same. It should be crisp all the way around. What I'll do is 10 minutes this side, then flip the aluminum foil, 10 minutes the other side. When we open that up, we should have some very golden, crispy little sardines. All right. Alright, this has cooled off a little bit, so we'll open this up. The dang house flies have found me. Let's just get one out of there and set it to the side over here. Oh man, they are nice. Little babies are, ooh, they're hot. They say you hold them in a piece of bread to eat them. Oh, careful, careful, careful. Don't want to drop these precious babies. Man, that's beautiful, folks. Ooh, hot, 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 hot.
hot and beautiful. Little pieces of oregano on there. Yeah, they're a little too hot yet for me. Let them cool off and then we'll try it. Get a zoom in for y'all. Isn't that lovely? Sardines. From the old country.
Alright, they're done. Here they are, folks. Let's just get one out of here. They're probably still hot, but I can't wait forever. Let's get one. Pull the skin off. Or not the skin, just pull some meat off here, off the body. Just break them in half and take a bite. Oh, tell you, buddy. Oh, and the bones are just like hair. They're little. Oh, man. This is delicious. It's salty, but it's not too salty. Not like an anchovy. I got flies landing all over me. And I got a dog right here begging. Don't worry, I'm gonna give you the bones. Okay. That was the side where the belly is. That did have some bones. Oh, look, that piece just fell off. Beautiful. There's a skeleton. See it? Come on, dog. Get it. Come on. Right here. I don't know if y'all can see it. Come on, dog. Get it. Take it out there. Nice piece. Oh. Lovely. Thank you, God. This is some of the best fish I've ever had. I'm not kidding. I mean, I can't explain it. I wonder if we could cook finger mullets like this. Isn't that beautiful? I guess it's a Spanish dish. They cook it on the beach, you know, all around Spain and Greece and down there. But I've always known they did this because I was in Greece. And I bought a cookbook and it said sardines. I just never got the guts to do it. So I was at H-E-B and they're selling them $2. A pound flash frozen, so I went ahead and bought a bag, about 2.5 pounds worth. That's what these were. And man, wow, I'm gonna get some more. All right, folks, that's it. We'll see you when we see you. Adios. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and comment. Bye. Adios. God bless.
Άνοιξα στο κήπο μου πηγάδι να ποτίζω τα πουλιά. Να έρχεσαι κι εσύ πρωί και βράδυ σαν μικρή δροσοσταλιά. Ήρθες μια βραδιά με τον αγέρα να στέναξει η καρδιά. Με λαχτάρα καλησπέρα και μου είπες γεια. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, δεν σε φίλησα ποτέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, πως να σε ξεχάσω Θεέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, δεν σε φίλησα ποτέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, μόνο στο όνειρό μου σε φιλώ. Πίτεψα στην πόρτα σου χορτάρι να έχεις ίσκιο και δροσιά. Κι ήρθα πριν να αλλάξει το φεγγάρι να σου φέρω ζεστασιά. Σε βγάλα στου ήλιου τα νηφόρη στα σοκάκια τα πλατιά. Μα ήρθε παγωνιά και ξεροβόρη και δε μ' άναψες φωτιά. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, δε σε φίλησα ποτέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, πως να σε ξεχάσω Θεέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, δε σε φίλησα ποτέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, μόνο στο όνειρό μου σε φιλώ. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, δε σε φίλησα ποτέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, πως να σε ξεχάσω Θεέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, δε σε φίλησα ποτέ μου. Μίλησέ μου, μίλησέ μου, μόνο στο όνειρό μου σε φιλώ.